The last thing I want to tell you before we go into programming is why this makes any sense. Suppose you fill the matrix, which I call omega, and the vector, which I give the Greek name of xi. My apologies to my non-Greek students here. You Greek students should be very proud. You always have a special place in my mathematical heart. Then I can find the best solution for all the landmark position or the world position by a very simple mathematical trick. And that is completely counterintuitive. I invert the omega, I right multiply with xi, and out comes a vector mu, which gives me the best estimates for all the robot locations and the landmark locations. Now that is quite amazing, because all it means in GraphSlam is that you keep adding numbers to these matrices every time you see a constraint. And when you're done with it, you run a very simple procedure, and out comes the best places for your robot. So let's go and try it. I'm not going to ask you to program this, and I'm giving you my matrix class, so you can do this easily. What I'm asking you to do is to build a 3x3 matrix, and of course a 3x1 vector, by which you shall state that our initial location is -3. x1 in exploitation is obtained by adding 5 to x0, and x2 is obtained by adding 3 to x1. So in expectation, what we should get out, we run the mu equals omega minus 1 times xi trick, that x0 becomes -3, x1 becomes 2, and x2 becomes 5. So diving straight into our programming environment, I'm giving you a matrix class. You might want to take a moment to look over it. It's a little bit augmented to what I've given you before, and I fixed a bug with the inversion code, which is quite essential. And if I run it, I construct an omega matrix piece by piece. That's the one that you should come out with. Xi vector. And then I run and print out using the show command the result of omega to the -1 times xi. And you can see -3, 2, and 5 are the correct result. They're the result from the omega matrix and xi vector. So what I want you to do is write code that incrementally, step by step, constructs the omega vector and the xi function, and then returns to me those results over here. There's an empty function in your code that accepts as parameter the initial position -3 and the two motion values 5 and 3.